And tonight, critics, including local Democratic lawmakers, are still concerned about whether the Postal Service is cut out to adequately handle and deliver mail-in ballots for the November election. Taisha Walker is live from Houston's 3rd Ward. And Taisha, there's now a call for a law to protect the Postal Service.
Yeah, that proposed bill is H.R. 8015, which members of Congress will vote on this coming Saturday. You know, Democratic leaders that represent the state of Texas say this isn't just about mail-in ballots. They say it's about everyday people trying to mail a letter or receive their prescription in the mail. And that's why they say it is important for them to come together on Saturday and make this proposed bill a law. The Postmaster General is doing an about-face. Louis DeJoy announced today that the USPS will halt all operational changes until after the November election. He says retail hours won't change. Mail processing equipment and collection boxes will stay where they are, and overtime for employees will be restored. Prior to today's announcement, 20 states threatened to sue after some mailboxes were removed and sorting machines stopped.
I do want to find out whether or not there have been any civil rights violations of denying people their mail,
yes.
Whether there have been any criminal activities,
yes.
Of taking up postal boxes. What authority did they have?
Three Texas Democratic congressional members held press conferences today where they call the operational changes on the USPS an attack. They say one organized by the nation's highest office.
The real question is, will those words really mean action? Or are they just going to be words on a piece of paper that go nowhere? And that may be moving forward, but what happens to all the damage that's already been done? Will they put all those blue boxes back where they were? Will they put back the machine?
DeJoy says the USPS is prepared to adequately handle election mail this fall. Representative Al Green says when fellow members of Congress meet on Saturday, he hopes they'll pass a law to restore the USPS to what it was at the beginning of the year.
Not making any more changes could mean that he is going to just stop and leave things as they are currently. My hope is that he would restore things to their status as of January 1st, 2020.
And those congressional members say their fellow members in the Senate need to pass the HEROES Act, which would grant the USPS $25 billion to continue to operate. We also know that the Postmaster General is scheduled to go before members of Congress next Monday. Reporting live from the 3rd Ward, Taisha Walker, KPRC, Channel 2 News.